姐妹们，大家早上好。
Good morning, brothers and sisters。
很高兴能够再次的在我们线上的聚会一起来敬拜神。
I'm glad to be able to worship together with you on our online service。
今天呢，我要讲的主题呢是关于一个品格。
Today I want to share about an attitude。
是一个很有趣的品格。
It's a very interesting character。
我自己个人本身很少会有这个关于这个品格的认识。
And to me personally, I find that I'm not very familiar with this attitude or character.
然后可能是因为这个世界上给这个品格的定义，就觉得成为一个这样的品格的人好像不怎么样。
Maybe because of the definition that's been given on this type of character, that I felt that maybe people with this kind of character, they are not very, they're not really something.
所以在我开始去看这个品格的时候，开始去做准备的时候，发现原来这个品格是很有能力的。
But when I started preparing and towards this topic, I find that this character is very powerful.
叫做我，所以我今天把我的题目放成 powerful gentleness, 就是一个有能力的温柔。
So today my topic that I'm going to share is powerful gentleness.
然后呢，我的经文是来自马太福音五章五节。
I'm going to quote from Matthew chapter 5 verse 5.
他说到温柔的人有福了，因为他们必承受地土。
It says, blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth.
当我们听到温柔这个词的时候，
when everybody hears about this term, gentleness,
它带来的感觉好像是很被动啊，非常的没有立场啊，软弱。
The type of feeling it brings may be of this type of person is very passive, is very weak, and they have no standpoint.
好像一个被 push over 的一个，然后呢，很任人摆布，被人欺负的一个感觉。
It felt like there are someone who are easily being bullied, easily being pushed around.
然后呢，在特别在这个充满愤怒跟竞争的时代里面，我们发现到温柔的人好像越来越少。甚至很难去成为温柔的人。
Especially in this type of world where it's full of anger, full of impatience, it feels like there's not really that many people who are gentle nowadays.
然后甚至也很难去成为一个温柔的人。
And it felt like it's even harder to become one.
然后最近我跟麦就看了一部的韩剧。
So recently, me and Joyce, we watched a Korean drama series.
然后在这套剧里面有个主角是一个70岁的老人。
So in this series, there's a character and the person is a 70-year-old man.
你可以看到这个老人真的是很不一样，因为他，我可以定义说我在看他的时候，我觉得他是一个温柔的人。
And in that story, you feel that this old man is very unique, is very different, and I can feel that this person in that story is very gentle.
他待人处事很温柔，就算他遇到人家里人的反对啊也好，他也很温柔。
The way he handles things and the way he treats people is full of gentleness.
他对一个他不认识的人也好，他对一个小过他年龄的人也好，他也体现出了一个我们所谓的温柔。
Be it to someone that is in his family or in his or stranger or someone that is younger than him, he is full of gentleness.
然后我在看那个剧的时候，我就觉得哇，这样温柔的人，特别是老人，而且还是一个男生，好像可能是因为戏里面需要打造这样的形象才会有的。这世上怎么会有这样温柔的人？
Now I was watching the movie and I felt that it'sPretty rare to have this kind of person in the real world. Maybe in the movie, that's how the character was built up to be. But then in this world, it feels like it's very difficult to have this kind of person.
其实也是因为看了这个老人的温柔，让我想，哎，我也想，我知道圣经里面提过温柔，我也想看看圣经是怎么样看温柔。
So when I watch about this old man, then it dawned upon me that maybe I would want to go back to what the Bible says about gentleness, try to look around what the Bible says.
就是圣经里面讲的温柔是跟人所想象跟知道的温柔是很不一样。
And the gentleness that's mentioned in the Bible are very different from the gentleness that's mentioned in our world.
首先，温柔这个词呢是在八福里面的第三福被提到的。
So first of all, the gentleness is in mentioned in the Sermon of the Mount, one of the Beatitudes.
然后呢，当中有的学者就把这个温柔提成温顺，或者是温柔，还是说谦和。
And some people will describe gentleness as being being with peace.
No humble, 谦卑。
And very humble.
Okay. 然后呢，在圣灵的果子里面，你不忘了温柔也是其中一个圣灵的果子。
And we also don't forget that gentleness is one of the fruits of the Holy Spirit.
在加拉太书五章二十二到二十三，圣灵所结的果子就是仁爱、喜乐、和平、忍耐、恩慈、良善、信实、温柔、节制。这样的事是没有律法禁止的。
In Galatians chapter 5, verses 22 to 23, it says, But the fruit of the Holy Spirit is love, joy, peace, forbearance, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Against such things, there's no law.
而且圣经里面有好多好多的部分的经文，旧约也好，新约也好，都提过温柔，要谦和，要温和。
In fact, in the Bible, from the Old Testament to the New Testament, there's a mentioning of that we must be gentle, we must be peacemakers.
在这里我会提一些，在以弗所书四章二节说到，凡事谦虚、温柔、忍耐，用爱心互相宽容。
For example, in Ephesians chapter 4, verse 2, it says, Be completely humble and gentle. Be patient, bearing with one another in love.
在提摩太后书二章二十五节说，用温柔劝诫那抵挡的人，或者神给他们悔改的心，可以明白真道。
In 2 Timothy chapter 2 verse 25, it says, Opponents must be gently instructed in the hope that God will grant them repentance, leading them to a knowledge of the truth.
加拉太书六章一节，弟兄们啊，若有人偶然被过犯所胜，你们属灵的人就当用温柔把他的心，对，温柔的心把他挽回过来。
In Galatians chapter 6 verse 1, it says, Brothers and sisters, if someone is caught in a sin, you who live by the Spirit should restore that person gently.
然后呢，在提多书三章二节说，不要毁谤，不要竞争，总要和平，向众人大显温柔。
In Titus chapter 3 verse 2, to slander no one, to be peaceable and considerate and always to be gentle toward everyone.
所以我们在这里可以看到，其实圣经很看重温柔这个事。
So we can see that actually the Bible emphasizes a lot on gentleness.
温柔其实在一个基督徒的生命当中是很重要的。
And it's a very important character in Christians.
不管是对人或是对神。
No matter towards God or towards other human beings.
所以我们要来看什么是温柔的时候，我们就要回到这个字眼的希腊原文里面看。
So to understand it further, we need to go back to maybe the definition of the word gentleness.
在希腊原文里面，温柔是 praus.
In Greek, gentleness is the word praus.
这个字眼呢，它是一个道德的用语，也指的就是一个人的一个品格。
This word is a moral term and it is a type of character.
所以，然后呢，在我们看古希腊哲学里面，有个学者就这样说，他说人应当追求一种美德，那个美德应该是一个中庸的美德。
In Greek philosophy, it was mentioned that human beings should pursue a kind of virtue, and this virtue is supposed to be the mean of virtues.
那中庸的美德指的是什么？就是在两个极端的中间，那就是一个中庸的美德。
What does it mean, the mean of virtues? It means between two type of extremes, we choose the mean point, the midpoint.
例如极度的浪费跟一个极度的吝啬中间出来的就是一个慷慨的美德。
For example, extreme waste and extreme stinginess in the middle is extreme generosity.
一个极度的鲁莽或是粗心，然后呢跟极度的一个恐惧当中，中间的就是勇敢的美德。
In extreme recklessness and in extreme fear, in between there is extreme courage.
因为过度的或者是不足的都是一个恶性的一个特性，而中庸是一个美德的特性。
Because both the two extremes are things that are not good, and then the mean of it are things that are good.
所以呢，只温柔是一个中庸的美德。
So gentleness is the mean of virtues.
那它的极端是什么？就是一个极端的不发怒和极端的发怒。
And both sides of the extreme, one side is you are extremely easy to be angered, and another one side is you are extremely not angered at all.
所以温柔不是指没有情绪的，是温柔柔柔弱弱的一个，不是的。
So gentleness doesn't mean that you are very weak and you cannot do anything.
因为当中它可以为他人发出公义的怒气。
Because that type of gentleness is something that you can bring out justice for other people.
它当中的那个怒气呢，是不自私的，不是为着自己的利益而自私的发怒。
And the anger inside is the anger that does not go for your own selfish needs and desires.
那从哪里可以看到？从耶稣的生命就可以看到。
from who can we see this type of example? We can see from it from the example of Jesus.
当耶稣发出义怒的那个时刻是在特别明显的什么？就是他到圣殿里面好多人做买卖的时候，然后变换钱财的时候，他就发出了义怒，翻了桌子。
So this type of anger that carries righteousness is like when Jesus went into the temple, he saw everybody was treating the temple like a market, then he was very angry and he flipped the table and things.
他的那个怒气是为他自己吗？不是，是为着神的国，因为他说这殿应该是一个祷告的殿。
So the type of anger is not for himself, but it's for God, because he says this temple is my Father's temple. It's a place of prayer.
所以我们可以看到，其实温柔并不是一个属于男性或女性的一个美德，它其实是一个基督徒有的品格，而且它不能男女有分别。
So there's actually no, it doesn't depend on gender when it comes to gentleness. There's no male or it's not suitable for only female.
而且呢，温柔并不代表，也并不是软弱的意思。
And it doesn't mean that you're weak.
温柔是可以勇敢、刚强、有力的温柔。
Gentleness means you are bold and you are courageous.
今天我们在待会我们讲的重点的时候，我们会围绕三个人物，就是耶稣、摩西还有亚伯拉罕。
So today as we talk about gentleness, we will revolve it around three people, that is Jesus, Moses and Abraham.
他们都是温柔的人。
They are people of gentle, they are gentle.
那我们刚刚提到说温柔可以是勇敢、刚强、有力的。
Just now we mentioned that gentleness, you can, even with gentleness, you can be bold, be courageous, be powerful.
耶稣、摩西、亚伯拉罕，他们是温柔的人，同时他们也是个勇敢、刚强的人。
And Jesus, Moses, and Abraham, they are all gentle people, but they are all very brave people.
在马太福音十一章二十九节，就是说到耶稣说：“我心里柔和谦卑，你们当负我的轭，学我的样式，这样你们心里就必得享安息。”
In Matthew chapter 11, verse 29, Jesus says, "Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls."
在马太福音二十一章五节也说到，要对西安的居民说：“看哪。”你的王来到你这里是温柔的，又骑着驴，就是骑着驴驹子。
In Matthew chapter 21 verse 5, he says, "Say to daughter Zion, see, your king comes to you, gentle and riding on a donkey and on a colt, the foal of a donkey."
在马太福音二十一章五节所提到的那个经文背景，就是当耶稣要光荣的进入耶路撒冷城的时候。
And this background mentioned in Matthew was when Jesus was about to enter into the city of Jerusalem.
我们可以仔细看到，温柔是耶稣生命的一个品格。
We can see very clearly that gentleness is part of Jesus' life.
然后呢，甚至当耶稣在他最低谷的时候，在面对十字架的苦难的时候。他温柔，他对于面对他的苦难，他却仍然有能力刚强。
Even when Jesus was towards the brink of his death, when he was about to be nailed on the cross, he is still very gentle, and that has become a part of his life.
在旧约里面，第一个有字眼提到说，他是一个温柔的人，就是摩西。
And another person that is mentioned in the Bible about gentle, that he is a gentle person, is Moses.
在民数记十二章三节。
In Numbers chapter 12, verse 3.
So, 摩西为人极其谦和，胜过世上的众人。
Says now Moses was a very humble man, more humble than anyone else on the face of the earth.
这里的谦和，它其实也指的是温柔。
The humble mentioned here also means gentleness.
温柔的摩西，你可以看到他勇敢的带领以色列人出埃及，甚至面对法老，还有面对许多的征战。
Now the gentle Moses was very brave in bringing the Egyptians out of the Israelites out of Egypt and in facing every single things that Pharaoh is throwing at them.
多么勇敢，多么刚强的一个。但是圣经也提到说他也是一个温柔的人。
He was very bold and very courageous, yet the Bible also mentioned that he is very gentle.
再来我们从亚伯拉罕跟罗德的事件里面，我们就可以看得出亚伯拉罕的温柔。
Another example is in the Abraham and Lot story, we can see how Abraham was very gentle.
待会我们提到的重点呢，都会围绕这三个人，我们会再更仔细的讲述他们的故事。
And we'll talk in more details their stories later.
所以呢，温柔使我们成为一个怎样的人呢
？So what kind of person does gentleness make you？
或是我们要怎么样成为一个温柔的人呢
？Or in other words, how do we be gentle？
然后我们在讲的时候，他当中就会提到说，我们怎么样可以活出温柔的生命。
And in amongst all this, we are asking ourselves how can we live a life of gentleness.
第一呢，就是温柔使我们成为顺服且愿意降服的人。
Number one, gentleness actually makes us into a very humble person and a person that's willing to obey.
在我们在刚刚前面提到说，温柔并不是没有情绪的，然后温柔当中仍然有怒气、有易怒的。
And gentleness, just now we mentioned, is not without feelings. We still have things like anger.
因为易怒的一个 justice 的justice 的anger. 哎，这个温柔呢，并不是只为着自己而发的，而是为着他人的益处而发出的。
This type of anger that is with justice is not for our own self, but it's for other people.
同样的温柔并不是为着自己，乃是为着他人的益处而发出的。
And this, because of this gentleness, is not for ourselves, but for other people.
当耶稣、摩西跟亚伯拉罕他们生命当中遇到羞辱、遇到攻击跟遇到挑战的时候，他们里面的温柔成了一个非常强大的力量。
When Jesus, Moses, and Abraham face trials and difficulties in their life, the gentleness inside of them have helped them to be to find the strength and power.
成为了一个很强大的力量来让他们面对。
And it becomes a very powerful force for them to face everything.
在这些挑战里面，他们并不会觉得哦，我要为我自己争取一些什么，或是为我自己谋取什么利益。
And this kind of challenges and trials, they're not thinking about how can they find things to benefit themselves.
或是要尝试得到自己所认为的公义，自己要去得到。
Oh, how can they find ways to find real righteousness for their own sake?
特别当摩西他被亚伦跟米利暗挑战的时候。
For example, like when Moses was being challenged by Aaron and Miriam.
刚刚我们所读到的经文就是摩西是个极其谦和的人。这个经文的背景就是在米利安跟亚伦来挑战摩西权柄的时候所写下的。
So this particular point where we mentioned that Moses was very gentle is happens when Aaron and Miriam was challenging the authority of Moses.
当时候他被挑战。
So at that time, Moses was challenged.
但是他的反应是什么？
But what was his reaction?
他没有做出任何的反应。
He didn't do anything.
反而他转向神，把这个权柄的事情降服给神。
He just turned to God and submit this authority to God.
然后呢，从经文我们之后可以看到是神亲自的来向亚伦跟米利安来证实。他给予摩西的这个权柄。
And the later part of the story, we see that God personally let Aaron and Miriam know the authority that he has given Moses.
我们再看耶稣，当耶稣被钉十字架的时候。
So let's look at Jesus. Before Jesus was nailed on the cross,
他说了一句话，他说，主啊，赦免他们，因他们不知道他们所做的。
He said something, God, Father, forgive them for they know not what they're doing.
这是耶稣的温柔。
This is the gentleness of Jesus.
他难道不能为自己争取吗？他没有权利去对抗吗？
Could he fought back? Could he find something to really seek benefit for himself?
难道摩西没有办法去直接对抗他们，捍卫自己，讲说我带你们出埃及，我没有那个能力吗？他们可以这样做吗？
Could Moses not just fight back against them and tell them it's I who bring you all out of Egypt?
但是因着他们绝对有那个权柄跟能力去对抗跟捍卫。
They definitely have the right to do so, and they definitely have the power to do so.
但是因着他们心里的温柔，当事情是关于自己的时候，他们然而把自己降服在神的主权里面。
But because of the gentleness in their heart, they understand this and they rather submit themselves to God.
他们降服谦卑在神的面前，因知道他们所拥有的一切都是来自于神。
They submit and obey God because they know that everything comes from Him.
因为他们相信神是会为他们伸张公义的，相信神的安排是对他们最好的。
They know that God's plan is always the best for them, and they know that God will put righteousness and justice for them.
温柔的人心总是向着神。
A gentle person's heart is always facing towards God.
他们不是要去选择哦，跟着他们一起去争啊、夺啊、抢啊。
They're not someone who is blindly going around to snatch and to fight with someone.
或是软弱的觉得哎呀没有办法了，给啦给你给你啦，你要怎样就怎样，不是的。
Or to feel weak and say I cannot do anything, just do whatever you want.
他们中间的能力跟刚强都是走向 我来向神来支取权柄。
In the midst of their power and their boldness is all in seeking God and turning to Him.
再来，在这个温柔里面的时候，可以看到温柔的人是极度的依靠神、信靠神的一个生活方式。
And we see that in gentleness, this people with gentleness are people that is extremely depending on God.
在活出温柔的时候，他们当中对神有带着一个非常深的信任。
In living out gentleness, they have this profound trust in God.
就好像在约翰福音五章十九节就有说到耶稣的生命，他说耶稣对他们说：“我实实在在的告诉你们，只凭着自己不能做什么，唯有看见父所做的，子才能做。父所做的事，子也照样做。”
In John chapter 5 verse 19, Jesus gave them this answer. Very truly I tell you, the Son can do nothing by himself. He can do only what he sees his Father doing, because whatever the Father does, the Son also does.
所以呢，温柔的人他们是极度的依靠上帝的帮助。
So people that are gentle are people that is depending on God.
甚至呢是极度的顺服上帝所说的。
They are obeying God to the extreme.
只有主说啊，只是主说什么我们才做什么。
And they, whatever the Father says, they will do.
甚至有一个人这样子解释温柔，他说温柔的人就是一个永远都会向神说 yes 的人。
And someone explained this in a simpler term is, people who are gentle are people who do whatever God says.
只要是神的旨意，是神所兴起的，他就会向神说 amen。
As long as it is God's will and is God's calling, they will say yes, amen.
所以呢，在温柔，在圣经里面的温柔不是软弱，而是呢会在上帝的主权当中操练神给我们的力量。
So the gentleness, the Bible is not weakness, is to exercise the power and the ability that God has given us.
在这其中，我们就会学习到怎么样聆听神的声音，然后呢完全的顺服跟降服。
And in the midst of it, we are learning to obey God and exercise listening to Jesus.
另外一个我很喜欢关于温柔的定义，就是讲说。温柔的定义是一个有能力的，却能够把能力控制下来的人，那叫温柔。
Another meaning and a definition of gentleness that I really like is gentleness is the ability to do it, but you have the ability to control.
这定义很关键。
This definition is very important.
它也是蛮中心的一个东西。
And it's also is a mean and a median of.Virtues.
然后呢，他是想说，就好像我们会形容一只动物非常的温顺啊，然后呢，哇，可爱的小狗它很温顺、很温柔，或是一个马匹它很温柔。
For example, we often see people describing this animal or this puppy or this horse is very tame, is very gentle.
它指的是呢，它是温柔的其中一个定义，也指的是经过一些训练就能够听从命令、能够顺从指挥，是能够愿意去聆听。
There's also this definition that says that gentleness comes through training. Well, after you are training and after some time, you learn and acquire this gentleness.
你知道，在动物里面，他们有他们的天性，有他们的冲动，他们是可以非常的wild 的，非常的狂野的。但是呢，可能在训练当中，一只野马也能成为一只温顺的马。
You see, to animals, there are some that are that have this wild nature in them. So even through training, a wild horse can be tamed and be gentle.
所以温柔是我们可以去控制我们里面的冲动，我们里面的天性，是我们需要懂得节制跟纪律的。
So gentleness, it means to control our own desires and ourselves, so that we have this ability to be gentle, this ability to show, live out gentleness.
以致呢，我们能够降服于神，不慌不乱的聆听神的旨意。
And to know and to listen to obey the word and the voice of God.
还很重要的是，在这里我们要怎么样成为一个温柔人？因为他是圣灵的果子，我们都需要圣灵的帮助。
So how do another point of how do we be gentle is we need to depend on the Holy Spirit because.The gentleness is part of the fruits of the Holy Spirit.
我们需要圣灵来帮助我们去控制我们里面的天性，我们里面的冲动，我们以前的老我，好让我们能够学习在圣灵里面做节制的人，纪律的人。
We need the Holy Spirit to discipline us and to teach us self-control so that we can be to live a self-controlled life and a disciplined life.
然后呢，我们这样才能够活出那个降服跟 跟啊、愿意降服跟顺服的一个温柔生命。
That's how we can live out a life that is willing to obey and willing to submit to God.
第二点，在温柔里面会让你成为怎样的人？它会让你成为一个谦卑的人。
Number two, having gentleness will help you to become a humble person.
温柔和谦卑常常是连接在一起的。
And humility and gentleness are often tied together.
就好像耶稣讲说，我心里柔和谦卑。
Just like Jesus says, I am humble and gentle.
而谦卑是一个很特别的东西，是我们自己可以选择，我们要从发自内心里面做一个谦卑的人。
And humility is a choice for all of us. We can choose to be humble from our heart.
就是在各样的事情里面，我们原本可以高傲的去反应，但是我们却可以靠着圣灵选择在自己的心里把心里的姿态放在一个谦卑的位置上。
In our life, there are many circumstances for us to boast ourselves, but then we always have a choice to choose to be humble at heart.
它是发自内心的，从心而发的。
And this is a humility that comes from your heart.
所以温柔其实也一样，也是发自内心，不是外表或行为的一个表现。
Likewise, gentleness also comes from your heart. It's not just outward appearance and portraying.
它不是讲说、哦、我的外表柔柔弱弱的，我就是个温柔的人，或者是我讲话细声细语的，我就是个温柔的人，不是这样的。
It's not if my action is seems like very soft and very gentle, or the way I speak is very soft spoken, that means gentleness. No.
他跟谦卑一样，是从内心发出，愿意把自己借着神上圣灵的力量，放在一个温柔谦卑的姿态。
It's like humility. It comes from your heart, and it stems from the gentleness that you have, and the heart that you have for God.
在圣经里面说到，摩西极其谦和，胜过世上众人。
And in the Bible, it mentions that Moses was humble and more humble than anyone on earth.
温柔的人不是懦弱的，不是软弱的，而是甘愿完全舍己的人。
And gentleness is not is someone that is willing to let go and sacrifice.
当我们把我们心里的姿态放下来的时候，我们就不再是为着我们的，而是为了他人。
When we are willing to put ourselves lower ourselves down, then our own self and our own benefit is no longer our priority.
而是为着神，为着他人。
But it's for others and it's for God.
这样的人呢，必然是一个灵性成熟、生命丰盛的人。
This type of person are very mature person and people that live abundantly.
因为他愿意降服，愿意舍己，所以当人他跟人互动的时候，他会谦卑下自己，会懂得怎么样温柔对待他人。
Because they are willing to submit and they are willing to sacrifice. So when they are dealing and working with other people, they are willing to be humble and be gentle.
另外一个有个学者也这样说，温柔是一个除去骄傲的真谦卑。
Another person says this: gentleness is the willingness to let go of your pride and in humility.
怎么样想说是除去骄傲的真谦卑呢？
So what does it mean when it says true humility by removing all our pride?
有的时候我们谦卑，但我们不愿意承认我们生命当中的问题、跟软弱、跟需要。
Sometimes we are humble, but we are not willing.To acknowledge the needs and the weaknesses in our life.
真正的谦卑是愿意来承认，向神承认我们生命当中是需要神的，是有软弱的，是有需要的。
True humility is coming before God and acknowledging that in our life we need Him and there are things that we cannot do without Him.
这样当中有着非常深厚的一个跟神的信任跟信赖。
And it's a very profound trust that we have towards God.
不是为了自己的利益去争夺，而是把主权交给主，在跟神相处里面选择谦卑的姿态。
It's not to fight for our own righteousness for our own benefits, but to wholly submit to God.
我们人常常就是想要为自己争取一些什么，或是想要为自己做一些什么，或要做一些事情来证明自己的能力，人家才可以看见到我是一个怎样的人。
Sometimes as human, we tend to want to portray, do something to show that we are righteous, to do something to show that we are doing the right thing.
但是我们生命中的一些软弱，我们却不愿意让人家知道。
Sometimes because of this kind of attitude, there are some weaknesses or needs in our life that we are not willing to let other people know.
甚至我们生命所经历到一些事情，我们都不愿意去承认，以致我们想要高傲的来展现我们自己，然后我们心中就失去了谦卑跟温柔。
In fact, sometimes something happened in our life, and yet we are not willing to acknowledge it, and we rather still want to show and boast in front of other people.
我很喜欢在 八福里面，其实温柔是第三福。
And the Beatitudes is the third Beatitudes mentioned in the Bible.
这前面的两个福是说到什么？虚心的人有福了，因为天国是他们的；哀痛的人有福了，因为他们必得安慰；再来是温柔的人有福了。
So the first two mentioned are the blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. And then it was mentioned, blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Then only it was mentioned, blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth.
我真正时刻的相信，当我们人经历过那个虚心或是邻里贫穷的过程的时候，然后呢，在为着我们自己的问题、我们的不足跟我们的罪来哀恸的那些人的时候，他最终才能够承受，成为变成一个温柔的人。
I personally truly believe that so long as we have gone through, as long as we have gone through the first two, that's the being poor in spirit and understanding those who mourn and really knowing the suffering and the state of their heart, then only we can truly be meek and be humble.
就是在生命里面需要经历一些的破碎跟磨练的过程，神塑造我们的过程，我们才能够真正知道我们多么需要神，我们才能够真正知道我们需要顺服、降服在神的面前。
In our life, we need to go through a lot of molding and a test of our faith. Then only we learn to really know to be humble and to really depend on God.
我们才能够真实的看见到怎么样成为一个温柔的人。
Then we can really see how can we really be someone that is gentle.
不然我们的血气、我们的肉身常常都会因着啊。我能够啊，我能够去争取啊，然后就失去了那个温柔跟谦卑的特质。
If not, our human nature will always tell us that we can try to get this, we can try to fight for this, and then we will not be gentle.
就好像摩西一样。
Just like Moses.
他在他生命当中，他四十年前，他在40岁以前，他是多么的光荣。
So in the past 40 years of his life, he lived a glorious life.
然后他是王，他甚至有他的愤怒去杀了一个埃及人。
And his power of the royalty, and in fact, he killed an Egyptian.
然后他进入到了一个只是一个生育跟结婚的那个过程，那四十年过程，一直到神再次呼召他。给予他呼召的时候
，Then he went through another 40 years of life, that is having a family and then getting married. Then only God called him back.
然后呢，在他的那个被神呼召的时候，他也显得非常不知所措，然后觉得啊，主我不能啊，我没有口才，我做不到啊。
And even when God called him, he was saying that God, I'm not very good at speaking and I cannot do this.
一直到神来应许他，然后真正帮助他带领以色列出到埃及的时候，在旷野的那四十年，一直到他被挑战他的权柄的时候。
Then only after the all through after the Exodus and God bring them out of Egypt and through the wilderness for 40 years.
我们可以看见到那个改变是多么的明显。
We can see the transformation in his life.
在最终他被挑战他的权柄的时候，他有那个能力，他有那个能力去反抗的时候，他却温柔的对待，把他降服于神，转向神。
So at the point of time when he was being challenged, he has already known to, and he has the ability to fight back, but no, he chose to submit wholly to God.
在摩西的生命当中，可以看到他被神磨练跟被神破碎的那个过程。
So in the life of Moses, we can see how he was being broken down and he was being rebuilt again by God.
过去的他认为他可以靠自己绝对是能够的，但是呢，经过破碎的他知道，他需要靠着那加给他力量的神。
In the past, he may feel that he can depend on himself and is really able to do it by himself, but then after that, he learned to depend on God who gives him strength.
他的生命也因此生出了温柔和谦卑。
And likewise, that's how his life lived out gentleness and humility.
神让我们经历生命的破碎，其实并不是因为神喜悦破碎我们。
God led us through a time of brokenness and brokenhearted, not because God is pleased with us going through such things.
他是喜悦要来使用我们。
But God is pleased when He think about how He wants to use us.
这就领到我们的第三个点。
So that brings us to the third point.
就是温柔的人是一个蒙福的人。
Is people who are gentle are people that are blessed.
在我们刚读到的马太福音五章五节是说到温柔的人有福了，因为他们要承受地土。
Just now in the very beginning, we read Matthew chapter 5 verse 5. It says, blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth.
在当时的经文的背景里面，听耶稣讲到的这些犹太人，他们肯定是一头雾水的。
And at that point of time, when all those Jewish leaders, when they were listening to the Jesus saying this sentence, maybe they are full of confusion.
为什么？因为他们的土地是被罗马军兵用武力、用蛮力去争夺、抢夺去的。那温柔的人怎么样能够承受地图？
Because to them, the very land that they are standing on are being taken away from them by force and by might from the Roman soldiers.
但这里耶稣所讲的承受地图是有好多的好几个的意思。
But Jesus said, those who are meek and gentle will inherit the earth.
这承受地图可以是神所赐予我们的祝福。
When Jesus talk about this, it can mean a lot of different things.
然后呢，它可以是神所给予我们的祝福。
It can be a blessing that God gives us.
它可以是我们的家庭、我们的事业、我们的工作、我们手中所有的一些福分，是神所给予的。
It can be blessings in terms of in our family, in our career, in our life, in our children.
但是有的时候，因为人的不温柔，我们变得没有办法去享受这些神所给予我们的祝福。
But sometimes because we human are not gentle, we are unable to receive the blessings from God.
但我们才会有跟家里的人啊吵吵闹闹，没有温柔的存在，我们没有办法享受神所给我们的一个家庭的祝福。
So we are unable to enjoy our family when inside of our family we are often quarreling, there's no gentleness.
然后或是我们对于我们有的钱财，我们觉得不够，我们没有办法，我们不够，我们要再靠自己得到更多更多，我们没有办法享受神已经给我们的祝福。
Or financially, we feel that we are never having it. We are never satisfied. We are always having not enough. So we are always looking and fighting and struggling for more.
因着神啊，因着我们神圣灵所给我们的温柔，神让我们可以得到的饱足，享受神的祝福、恩典跟喜乐。
Because of the gentleness that God has given us, we can learn to be satisfied and to really enjoy what God has given us.
那我相信承受地土当然也包括了为主得着灵魂。
And then I believe inheriting the earth is also including winning souls for Christ.
这是神给我们的大使命。对，
This is the great commission that God has given us.
他最需要我们做的就是我们要去得人如得鱼。
What God needs us to do the most is to be fishers of men.
就好像约书亚在民生命记里面提到说，我们凡脚掌所踏之地，都是我们所以可以得着的这些祝福。
Just like in Deuteronomy, that like what Joshua says, wherever our feet leads to is.This land will be inherited and will be ours.
就算为主得灵魂
，and it's to win souls for Christ.
当我们心中有温柔、有谦卑的时候，其实我们可以让人感受到爱。
When we have humility and we have gentleness in our life, we can let other people feel the love of God.
我们能够把真正的能够完全体现出神的样式。
We can portray and let other people have a glimpse of God.
不管是我们对于神的降服，或是我们说话的姿态，或是我们心中谦卑的姿态，这一切都能够让人感到温暖。
No matter the way we submit to others, or the way we deal with other people, the way we react, all these areWe are able to testify and witness for God.
在说到承受地图，我也相信神也是指的应许的是我们在将来在天上的基业。
And of course, inheriting the earth also mean that we are able to have eternal life.
享受继承那个天上神所给予我们的基业。
And inherit what God has prepared for us in heaven.
就在彼得前书一章四节说，可以得着那不能朽坏、不能玷污、不能残衰残，为你们存留在天上的基业。
And just like in First Peter chapter 1 verse 4 says, and into an inheritance that can never perish, spoil or fade, this inheritance is kept in heaven for you.
当我们有温柔的时候，我们可以享受那天上各样丰富神所预备给我们的属灵产业。
When we have gentleness, we can enjoy and inherit every single thing that God has prepared for us in heaven.
我们才能够聆听神的心意，去做神要做的事啊。
Because when we are gentle, then only we can hear what God wants us to do.
就好像亚伯拉罕跟罗德的生命。
Just like in the life of Abraham and Lot, the incident.
然后在创世纪十三章里面有提到整篇的故事。
So the whole story was mentioned in Genesis chapter 13.
那他们的两边的牧人开始争草啊，争水啊。不够土地了啊。
So the shepherds from both sides are fighting for land.
然后在 13章第八节的时候就说到，亚伯兰就对罗德说，你我不可相争，你的牧人和我的牧人也不可相争，因为我们是骨肉，遍地不都是在你眼前吗？请你离开我，你向左我就向右，你向右我就向左。
And then in verse 8, Abraham says this. So Abraham said to Lot, let's not have any quarreling between you and me, or between your herders and mine, for we are close relatives. It's not the whole land before you. Let's part company. If you go to the left, I'll go to the right. If you go to the right, I'll go to the left.
在这里我们看到亚伯拉罕多么的温柔。
We can see how gentle Abraham is in this story.
他是长辈。
Although he's the senior.
他绝对有那个权利先选。
He has the right to choose first.
但是呢，他没有这样做。
But he didn't do so.
甚至呢，他很谦和的，他没有在责怪罗德，哎，为什么你的牧人要跟我争啊？他很谦和的说，我们不能相争，我们是骨肉。
And with gentleness, he didn't even fight and he didn't even question why Lot's herders, shepherds are fighting over the land. He just says, we are both close relatives.
然后我们可以看到，哇，在这人的逻辑里面，这样子先让罗德先选，这样子是一个，是没有一个，是一个好像很劣势的一个情况。
Now in human logic, to let other people choose first, this seems not right at all.
为什么？因为在人的逻辑，有优先权先选，你就可以选最好的、最优越的。
Why? Because in human logic, to choose first is better because you get to choose the best.
像小孩子看到一个蛋一盘的蛋糕，他们在选，他们就会先选，可以选那个最大最美的。
Just like for children, when they're choosing a parts of the cake, if they choose first, they get to choose the biggest part. They get to choose the one that they like the most.
然后可以选择那最大个的苹果来吃
，or maybe the biggest slice of apple。
但是呢，在亚伯拉罕跟罗德的这个世界里面，可以看到亚伯拉罕心里真正的知道，谁选都不重要。
But for Abraham,
先选都不重要。
But for Abraham, in this case, he knows deep in his heart that whoever they choose first is not important.
因为他心中对上帝有一定的相信。
Because to him, he knows in his heart he trusts God.
因为他是要从神的角度来看，真正的产业、真正的地、真正的祝福，其实并不是在那个物质本身。
Because in God's perspective, to him, he knows that the whole assets, the whole possession and everything, all the inheritance is not on materialistic things.
而是在人的心。
But it is in human heart.
是在人的心。
But it's in human's heart.
真正的祝福是源自当你处在一个蒙福的状态，你的心先让你的心成为一个蒙福的心。
The true blessing is to understand that when you're living in blessing, you let your heart to be the one that is blessed first.
你先选择那个神要我们拥有的姿态，那谦卑温柔的姿态。
You choose the type of attitude that God wants us to have first, that is to be gentle and be humble.
甚至呢，是不是争夺的，不是去愤怒的那个谦卑的姿态。
And attitude that is not to go out and lash out in anger.
这样我们就活在一个蒙福的状态。
And with that, we live in a very blessed state.
因为神要祝福的不单单是你的物质，不单单是在那片土地让你承受土地，神要祝福的是祝福你这个人。
Because God not only wants to bless your possession, the land that you're currently in, but God most importantly wants to bless you too.
在亚伯拉罕的这个故事里面，这个世界里面就可以看到，虽然亚伯拉罕不是先选的，就是留下来给他的，看起来不是怎么样的，但是呢，神因着他的温柔，应许了他美好的这个应许。
So in the later part of the story, we see that although Abraham didn't get a first choice, but then we see that God, in the end, he blessed Abraham with the rest of the things.
亚伯拉罕因着他的温柔，然后呢，他先让罗德先选，他甘愿接受那差的，他的这个温柔的生命的姿态是蒙上帝的喜悦的。
And the way Abraham deal with things, his gentleness is one that pleases God.
也让神呢就给了他一个能够承受地土，然后呢能够后裔遍满地的一个应许。
And because of that, God promised him, and God allows His will that is to let Abraham have descendants that is countless beyond the stars and the sands on the sea.
最终他得到的是更美的地。更美的地方。
So in the end, what he inherits is far better than what he at first have to choose with.
所以温柔的人不是去争夺自己想要的。
So gentleness is not fighting for what you want.
而是呢，看什么是神要的，相信神，信靠神。
but to choose what God wants and to trust on Him.
这样你知道为什么神会说温柔的人他可以放心的交托给他们承受地图吗？
Do you know why God is willing to let people who are meek to inherit the earth?
因为他知道他们当中有温柔、有谦卑、有顺服、有降服的心。
Because God knows that people who are with gentleness, they are people who are humble, they are people who are willing to obey and submit.
就算呢，神把他们提高到至高处，或是呢，把这些丰富的产业交给他们，也知道不会，这些事不会让温柔的人有任何的亏损。
So God knows that even if God exalts them or even if God gives them multiple possessions, God knows that they are able to handle things and they will not cause loss to themselves.
因为这样子的一个姿态，这样子的一个品格在当中的时候，他们不会因着拥有神的应许，然后就高高自大的。
Because with this type of character in them, they will not exalt themselves or pride.
因为呢，温柔谦卑的人知道如何降服于神，神是值得信任他们的。
They will not pride themselves and they are willing to submit and know that God is still over them.
所以让我们成为一个温柔的人。
So let us be people who are gentle.
真正的温柔是勇敢的。
A true gentleness is a boldness and with courage.
真正的温柔是能够使我们 因着神圣灵的缘故，我们能够降服，我们能够顺服于神。
A true gentleness is by the power of the Holy Spirit we are able to be humble and submit.
一个真正的温柔是让我们能够更多的信任、信靠神。
True gentleness allows us to trust and depend on God even more.
相信神，他所安排的是最好的，所给我们所谋的是最好的。
Is to believe that God's plan for us and everything that God has in mind for us is the best.
真正的谦卑，真正的温柔，是能够经历生命的破碎之后，知道神喜悦使用我们。
True gentleness is after going through the God breaking us and rebuilding us, we know that God has a greater plan and a good plan for us.
真正的温柔是能够使我们成为蒙福的人。
And a good true gentleness is knowing that God wants us to be blessed.
所以温柔的人有福了，因为他们必承受地土。
So blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth.
神的心意从以前到现今到永远都是一样。
God's will from last time till now is the same.
让我们成为一个温柔的人。Let
us be people who are gentle.
因为成为温柔是有能力的。Because
being gentle is powerful.
让我们来做一个结束的祷告。Let
us end with a prayer.
求神来祝福我们，甚至求神来帮助圣灵来帮助我们成为温柔。May
God bless us, may God help us to be people who are gentle.
因为温柔是一生的学习。Because
this gentleness is a life lesson.
温柔是一生我们都要去追求的。
It's something that we pursue in our whole life.
因为它能够为我们的生命带来能力。
Because it can change and transform our life.
亲爱的父神，
Father in heaven,
我们感谢你。
We thank you.
你教导我们温柔的功课。
You teach us about gentleness.
我们可以看见到你就是那温柔的形象。
We see that you are the God that is gentle.
你造我们，也要我们有着温柔的形象。
And when you created us, you also wanted us to be gentle.
好，让我们能够成为蒙福的人。
So that we can be people who are blessed.
好，让我们能够成为一个承受主你福分的，你应许的人。
So that we can become people that inherit your will.
你让我们能够成为一个谦卑顺服的人。
So we can become people that is submissive and people that obey you.
能够成为一个完全信靠你的人。
To become people that trust in you.
主，让我们在我们的生命当中学习温柔。
Lord, let us learn to be humble in our life.
圣灵来到我们的生命里面，使我们成为温柔。
May Holy Spirit come to our heart and let us be gentle.
在神里活出温柔的生命，在人我们也活出温柔的形象。
God, help us to live out a life of gentleness.
我们知道我们需要这样做，我们才能够更多的承载主你的福分。
We know that when we do this, Lord, we can inherit more of your promise and your blessings.
是你给予我们 的这个的祝福。
And this is the blessing that you have for us.
我们谢谢赞美你。
We thank you and we praise you.
愿今天我们所分享的这个的经文跟这个的信息能够深深的烙印在我们的心里面。
May the scripture and may the sermon that is shared this morning can be deeply rooted in our hearts.
让我们能够活出温柔。
So that we can live out gentleness.
以温柔的心把人带到主你的面前。
So that we can lead other people with gentleness to you.
谢谢耶稣。
We thank you, Jesus.
我们感谢祷告。
We thank you and praise you.
是奉主耶稣基督的圣名。
In Jesus' victorious name we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
赞美主。
It is a wonderful privilege given to us to give to the Lord.
对我们来说，是上帝给我们的特权来能够来奉献给他。
Our giving is a worship unto the Lord.
我们的奉献是一种献祭的方式。
And sometimes we have to give sacrificially also.
有时我们要以牺牲的方式来给。
But I believe the Lord sees your giving.
我相信上帝看到你的付出。
And he will bless you abundantly in return.
他会大大的祝福你。
I ask Sister Suli to pray for the offering at this time.
我叫Suli姐妹来为这一个奉献来祷告。亲阿爸天父，我们满心感谢你主，感谢你赐我们一个丰盛的生命，也给我们在这疫情当中有着平安。主啊，我们现在要为我们的奉献来祷告。主，我们晓得你是我们的耶和华以勒，我们的供应者，求你让我们每一个人都以一个甘心乐意的心来奉献给你，来让这些奉献成为你，来扩充你的国度。奉主耶稣的名我们祷告，
Amen。
Brothers and sisters, you can give your tithes and offering via online banking.
弟兄姐妹们，你们可以给予你们的奉献和使用奉献透过网上银行支付的方式。
Kindly email your banking slip to church or WhatsApp to Sister Chua Siuli.
请在奉献之后呢，把银行收据邮寄给我们的教会或者信息给蔡秀丽姐妹。
Thank you and God bless you.
谢谢，愿神赐福。
Brothers and sisters, thank you for joining our online service.
弟兄姐妹们，谢谢大家参与我们的线上聚会。
Here are some announcements for this week.
这是我们这个星期的报告。
Next week, we will be having Holy Communion.
下个星期我们将会有圣餐主日。
You may acquire the communion emblems from your respective cell leaders.
你们可以向你们的小组组长索取这个的圣餐的饼和杯。
If you do not have a cell group, you can prepare your own emblems or you can contact Brother Joseph.
若你没有隶属任何的小组，你可以自行准备你的圣餐饼和杯，或是你可以向超级弟兄索取。
Every Wednesday at 8 p.m. we will have our online prayer meeting.
每个星期三晚上八点钟，我们在线上有 Zoom 祷告会。
It will be on Zoom app and you can acquire the link from your cell leaders.
我们将会使用 Zoom 来进行祷告会，你可以向你的家庭小组组长领取网址。
Cell groups will be done online as well.
我们的家庭小组也会用线上的方式进行。
You can acquire more info from your respective cell leaders.
请弟兄姐妹向你们各自的小组领袖获取更多的资讯。
We are constantly updating our church official website with exciting news and information.
我们会定时在教会官方网站更新更多的资讯和内容。
Be sure to check them out at livingwaterdampin.com.
欢迎大家浏览以下网址 livingwaterdampin.com.
That is all for our announcement this week. God bless you.
这就是我们这个星期的报告，愿神赐福大家。